Hi everyone, how's it going? This is Ash and a warm welcome to my latest model train review video. This is a review of another Hornby Class 60, as I have recently been increasing my model train collection, and this is originally a 2016 release in the DB Schenker DRAX silver livery, and this one is numbered as 60066 with the reference number that is 3479 or R3479 in the DRAX COCO diesel electric class 60, numbered as 60066. As with the recent reviews, I'm just going to turn the box around for those of you that want to read the details on the back, and you can just pause the video to read this if you wish, as I do promise to cut down on the waffle in my reviews and keep them straight to the point. So therefore, I'm just going to pause the video for a wee moment and I shall remove the packaging, including the blister packaging. Okay, now that I've removed the packaging of the Hornby Class 60, I'm just going to swiftly go through the instructions, as this is kind of mundane stuff that I don't wish to spend too long on. But this just shows you how to lubricate the areas of what needs lubricating, as well as fitting a DCC chip. But apart from that, that's all there really is to cover in the instructions. Hornby do include a set of detailing parts, but for some reason, during 2016 and 2015, and this was particularly the case with 60090 that I used to have, which was the British Rail coal sector one, you only get one flush snowplow and one semi-open one instead of two of each. But in 2017, Hornby did correct this, as they give you two of each to give you a choice. So a big thumbs up to Hornby on that. Which means we can now move on to the most enjoyable part of the review, and that is the model locomotive. On first impressions, the model is very nice for weight. As per the other Class 60s that I have, this is the DB Schenker DRAX livery. This one does have sprung buffers. It does have the DB logos on the front. However, the DB Schenker logos appear to be missing on the sides. I'm not sure if this is how the prototype is, as I've not seen 60066 in the flesh, but it does have the grey roof as per the DB red versions. And talking of DB red versions, I would really like it if Hornby would consider making a model of something like 60063 in the DB Schenker standard livery, or perhaps 60100 in the DBC large logo red livery, as those two models would be most welcome into the Hornby range. And fingers crossed, hopefully for the Hornby 2019 range. I'm not sure if the camera is picking the details up, but it appears that these Hornby models, inside the cab, the controls and the speedometer, the ammeter, and everything is really, really nicely picked out inside the cab. And I do plan to add a Kato driver into this one, along with 60087 and the repainted 60062, as I believe a driver really does make these models look absolutely superb and very realistic. You have got the silver painted exhaust pod, as some of them do have a oxidized orange color, depending on the model that you choose, of which they have. However, there is a detraction with this model that I have noticed. There's no painted footsteps, and I have fitted the coupler onto the train ready to go, as there will be a test run to follow from this review. As per my recent reviews, I will not be giving a final score on this model, as everybody's opinion will differ considerably, and everybody has judges things individually, and therefore that is my reason behind it. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to pop the Class 60 onto the test track, and we will see this model in action. But before I stop this video and reposition the camera, I just want to point out that there is a switch on the underside of the fuel tank, and the model does have opening cab doors as well as the usual sprung buffers and the NEM coupler sockets. However, in my opinion, the cab doors are just really a gimmick, as it's not really a function that I really use, but it is nice to of Hornby to include this anyways. Now we have 6066 on the track and ready for the test run. And I'm going to start with a slow pull off, just to show the head and tail lights in action. I'm currently running this train on 40% power from the Kato controller. Just to demonstrate how smooth and good quality these model trains really are. And now the camera, correction, the locomotive is out of view. I'm just going to increase the power to 50%. As this locomotive is still brand new and it's not had much of a running session at all, it is recommended to give all brand new model trains a running session of 30 to 45 minutes in this direction at about 50% power, as this will allow the gears and the drive line to bed in. As you can see, the model is fairly quiet compared to the leaner version, which is much of a noisier model in comparison. And I do plan to install DCC sound into this model, as well as the other two Hornby Class 60s that I've covered, including the 6062 and 6087. I do plan to get the Hornby DRAX hopper biomass wagons that were a limited edition, as I'm after approximately 10 of them just to run behind either a Class 60 or a Class 66, as I have filmed many of them at Barnetby in the past when I was living in England, and they would make a nice train to go behind the DRAX Class 60, even though the real wagons do run behind the Class 66 from my observations anyways. In addition to the DRAX wagons, I am hoping to get some of the Revolution Trains TEA 100 ton tankers in 00 gauge, as I think 10 of them would look grand behind a Hornby Class 60, and from what I have read about them, they do have a nice amount of weight to them, which should test the haulage capabilities of the Hornby Class 60 models. So that is another wagon that I'm looking forward to adding to my model train collection. But that aside, I will be getting some more standard wagons for model train running sessions that I do plan to do, as having a freight train, a generic freight train and a generic passenger train, it just adds more variety to the video, which personally I feel it makes it more fun to watch. But anyways, I've been filming for nearly 6 minutes, so what I'm going to do is allow one more pass and then I shall wrap up this video. As always, I do appreciate all positive and constructive feedback on my content that I create. Until next time, have a good week or weekend. Take care and cheerio. Thank you for watching.